Yeah, thanks for showing up to this event. This is an info session for the next Davey Foundation grant, and this is David. I can tell you a little bit about myself, as well as Cara. I'm the vice president of the board on the foundation, and I'm also a filmmaker myself. We live here in Miami, Florida, and would you like to talk about yourself? Introduce yourself.
Sure. I'm Cara Despain. I am an artist, and I'm also on the board of the Davey Foundation. And I guess my relationship to film is that I helped with Kenny's film, The Strongest Man, that we shot here in 2014. It went to the Sundance Film Festival. I was the art director. I don't know much else about making films beyond that. But being on the board, I've read a lot of scripts, kind of helped with the process of producing the short films, or at least getting them ready to screen and part of our showcase.
In other words, she knows a lot more about film than she lets on.
Than a regular old artist. Regular old dummy artist.
Well, we can talk about the mission.
Okay. Did we do it?
Yep.
Okay. So the full title, the David Ross Fetzer Foundation for Emerging Artists, is a bit of a mouthful, but it's important in the sense that we want to, by our title, underscore what our mission is, which is to support young filmmakers, young because they tend to be emerging, they tend to need more support than later career artists. We're not trying to be ageist, but we're just trying to, you know, have one criteria that focuses in on a particular group.
Yeah, and why we understand emerging is
a hard word to define.
Word, because, you know, a lot of people that are 65 are just getting into filmmaking because there is no real age boundaries for cinema. And the reason why we are limiting it at 35 or younger is just to try to catch these emerging filmmakers at this particular moment in their development, in their voice. So the actual mission is?
Born of love, dedicated to creative collaboration and community engagement, the Davey Foundation provides grants, mentoring, and opportunity for emerging artists in film and theater. So we can just briefly explain the theater part. I know it's not relevant to you all at this moment, but David, as a person, he was an actor, a musician, a writer, and he was involved in lots of different things that were creative, and theater was a big part of his life, too. He was a fantastic stage actor. He was also an amazing film actor. But the theater grants that we offer are in collaboration with two entities in Salt Lake, two theater companies there, and that's a staged reading for one playwright to kind of see their play in that phase, you mm-hmm. know, getting actors to kind of read it. And then the other one is doing a full production play. And then we also have our film life.
Which is what you guys are here
for. And
I skipped this still image. This is from Lauren Wolkstein's Davey Foundation-funded short film called Bemis, It'll End in Tears. And this film was recently selected for the South by Southwest Film Festival. Very excited about that. So yeah, a little bit about who David was. I'll try to keep it brief because of time, but David was our best friend in Salt Lake City. I grew up with David as well as other members of the board. He passed away at the end of 2012 from a painkiller overdose, and he was just a kind of a all-encompassing creative being. You know, he was just this beautiful spirit that was an amazing filmmaker, writer, musician, actor, kind of all across the board, and he really pushed others to be as passionate as he was. And he was very infectious, you know, he just had that energy. So, you know, when he passed away, we all got together and decided, oh, we have to do something for Davey, something that carries on his legacy. And from that, the foundation was born.
I mean, essentially, it was because David was, despite how immensely creative and talented he was on his own, he was always, always putting other people's projects first and holding everybody else up and helping them to make their dreams come true. So the foundation very much carries on that idea of helping other artists, lifting them up and helping them make their projects.
So, much of the foundation is a vehicle for mentorship and support outside of just...
Here's the cash.
outside of just money or...
Which is great.
Gear incentive, which we understand everyone needs, but we're really trying to do more as a organization and provide feedback and peers and things like that. And we'll talk a little bit more about that. This is a still from Nick Dixon's short film that from our last year's grantees called Mine, which this is actually very impressive because he shot a film that was to take place in the Middle East, but he cheated it and used a canyon in Utah, which has a great mountain desert landscape.
He was our local grantee. Yeah, so we have three national grants and one that's just for Utah filmmakers, and we'll talk more about how and why we want to support them. You want to?
Sure. Yeah. So why did we choose to support short films? For us, we see short films, or, you know, as a filmmaker, I see it as extremely important for the growth of a filmmaker's style and career. You know, it leads to the development of a feature film, or it can. But it in itself is also just an art form. The short film is an art form, and I think it's being recognized more and more for that today than more than ever. You know, we're in an age of so many different types of media consumption that it's not just, you know, short films that go to festivals and die. You know, now they can actually be picked up by Netflix or, you know, a VOD platform, or they can be picked up by an airline and played as you're taking a flight, which I have a friend that had that happen recently. So that right now is a good time to be creating short form material. You know, I'm always hesitant to throw around the word content, but you know, right now we are in an age of digital content, and a lot of companies and organizations are after that, and we want to support the filmmakers to kind of come into their own through that medium. Let's see. Oh yeah, and there's also very little support right now for short filmmakers, as I'm sure you've tried to make short films yourselves. It's difficult, and...
Yeah, and applicants have said that over and over and over.
Yeah,
even people that didn't get the grant, you know, were saying, like, it's really great that you're doing this because there are so few short film grants out there.
Right, and if you do a little Google search, it's, you know, it's pretty evident.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we pop up pretty high on the list there, but there's just not a ton of resources for the amount of filmmakers there are.
Yeah, I mean, just to kind of illustrate that and to maybe, like, toot our own horn a little bit, but we've given two rounds of grants now in short films, and the first year we got 150 submissions, which was still pretty great for just a brand new baby organization, and then the second year it jumped to 415, and it went out in No Film School, right?
And
IndieWire. So as soon as people caught on to the fact that we were giving money away for short films, I think just the amount of applications alone speaks to what's lacking
in
the
need.
Production world of short films. So we're kind of happy to be providing that, putting money into that negative space.
And, you know, as far as speaking on a personal level, David was very passionate about film and very critical. And for him, you know, the art of storytelling was the most important thing, and that's kind of why we focused not just on finding short films and, you know, merely creating a festival, but also producing our own work, is that he always wanted to, you know, support interesting, innovative, different types of storytelling. You know, even traditional storytelling that is compelling and well-crafted is also so important. So we kind of are our umbrella is pretty broad to what we're after. Oh, and also, you know, our organization is based in Utah, the home of, you know, one of the largest festivals in the world. So we really want to try to foster and develop relationships between Utah and the rest of the nation. So,
and yeah, again, David, it was so important to him to have good work coming into Utah from the outside. And by doing that, it also helped the local folks make better work because they kind of rise to the level. Not to say that there aren't people already at the level, right? But in terms of like, oh, why are you giving this grant away and making people go to Utah? That's part of our mission. But also, it's a way for the filmmakers to come together and to kind of get to know that community. And again, the proximity to Sundance, it sort of makes sense to make those relationships. These are the grants.
So this year we have two national grants of $5,000 each, and one national gear incentive grant that is valued at $10,000. So this is basically a camera rental package sponsored by our friends in Texas, Film Exchange, and they've been generous enough to do this for a couple years in a row now. They have several different camera package options, so we'll work with you to work with them and pick what's right for you, for your project. And
they have lighting, sound,
no
as well.
Lighting, just
no
sound,
lighting, just sound,
and camera package.
Okay, and they have fancy stuff.
Yeah.
C300
is what Mine was shot with. Uh-huh. I mean, Nick Dixon's short film called Mine.
Oh, right.
As well as my
right.
film,
that
actually.
Was confusing
I also
as hell.
Shot
yeah.
my film with a C300. He has a C500 available, Blackmagic Ursa, things like that. So, or if you're shooting multiple camera, he has a bunch of Blackmagic mm-hmm. production cameras. So, and then this doesn't apply to you guys, but we also do a Utah grant that's $2,500 yeah. plus our partnership with Averick Art House, which is a film collective, much like Indie Film Club or Borscht or whatever. They have a facility in downtown Salt Lake. So for the local, it's a pretty awesome
yeah,
partnership.
And it's a nice way to collaborate with another local entity.
So, yeah, we talk about film family a lot because, as you guys know, if you've ever worked a film set, you become family with everyone that's working it because you are living and working in such close proximity that you really leave the production feeling like family. And we're kind of into nurturing our filmmakers in the same way. So our board is comprised of filmmakers, both documentary and narrative, and both feature and short. Actors and artists, and then friends and family of David's. We're spread out. You know, the main location, you're an airplane, main location
Hold your sound.
Of the foundation is in Utah. We're spread between LA and Miami and New York, and then other pals in the Northwest and just kind of everywhere. So,
yeah, and as we grow, you know, we want to have kind of fingers in different parts of the country because we do want to create partnerships. Despite our kind of Utah-centric programming, we also want to be something that is very...
We're building
yeah.
our web. So
yes.
We can offer more support
yeah.
to more filmmakers everywhere.
Yeah, and as we kind of grow our film family, you know, all the grantees are our buddies now. We've really lucked out on having such a great group of people, just as people, but also now it's like, oh, have you ever used this person for a sound guy? Have you ever applied to this festival? What's it like? You know, there's a lot
yeah,
of... It just expands. Yeah, it expands everybody's kind of mobility within the indie film world.
Right. And
which is awesome.
Here in Miami, we definitely wanted to give a little shout out to other indie film entities who are doing awesome stuff because we're not the end-all be-all, especially locally. You know, you can find Filmgate and Borscht and Miami International Film Festival and Miami Short Film Festival and I'm running a roundtable, screenwriters roundtable group where we get together and read new material. So there's lots of other resources in Miami. And this whole thing, even though we're pitching this to Miami, as the rest of our board members will pitch it to their city that they live in, there's no guarantee that anyone from Miami will get it. I just really want that to happen. So
yeah, we had several Miami scripts last year.
Yeah, actually,
one was a really good contender. Yeah. But I mean, you know, we're talking about this wonderful experience that happens with the showcase. So, and we live here. We would love at least for people to apply and have the chance of coming out and being there.
Yeah, and ultimately, it's our jurors' decision. But you know, the more projects that come out of here, the better, I think.
Yeah.
This is a still from another short film by Stephen Lee that is really beautiful and touching.
Yeah, this was a really amazing cinematography, mm-hmm. actually. That was like really outside of the box.
Let's see. Okay, application and jury process. This is some of the dates you were asking about. It's March 22nd is our regular application period that is coming up, so pretty...
It's open now, that's the soon. Deadline.
Yeah, we just passed our early bird, so now our regular
and
window
is
open.
And how much is that? Because the early... Well, we don't need to talk about the discount for the early ones, because we'll get depressed, but the regular fee is...
I don't know off the top of my head. We should have included it.
But, I know, I was going to look, and it wasn't on our...
It goes up in increments, so yeah. Early bird is the cheapest, regular is a little bit more, late is getting... even more, and then I think Without a Box has a...
If you're a member.
If you have an account, then you get like an extra special deadline, but apply early. It makes our life easier and your life
cheaper.
let's see. Oh yeah, on the website, thedaveyfoundation.org is where you can find all this information and the link to the Without a Box application, which is the kind of third party we're using now. You're familiar with it if you've applied to festivals before. This is the exciting part.
You guys are hearing it first.
Actually, yeah, we haven't actually announced this yet. We're going to do No Film School is going to do a little thing on us, but we can let you guys know the jurors for this year will be Sean Baker, who did an amazing and well-known film called Tangerine, shot on the iPhones, everyone knows about it, as well as Amy Siemitz, who has a Florida connection. I believe she's originally from here.
Really?
But she's done some Borscht projects, mm-hmm. and amazing actor as well as filmmaker, so we're really excited to have her and Sean, both of them, on. Last year's jurors were the Zellner brothers, who did Kumiko the Treasure Hunter, and awesome Austin-based filmmakers who are exploding right now. Basic criteria, script should be no longer than 16 pages. You have to be 35 years old or under.
And that's for the writer-director.
Yeah, writer-director. We're really trying to find the writer-directors.
Yeah,
we're
to
not
apply.
Excluding...
producers,
yeah.
Whatever, from applying. But the writer-director, even if the producer applies...
The writer-director needs to be 35.
Yes. Yeah, there can't be under. That can't be a sidestep to get around the age cutoff.
Yeah.
We're on to you.
We're on to you. There's only so much cheating you can do. right now, we get a lot of questions about post-production funding, which is maybe a grant that, you know, we'll talk about opening in the future with our board. Because there's definitely a need for it. We get a lot of questions about it. But right now, we're trying to take projects from, you know, script to screen. So
we're trying to be that extra bit that makes it happen.
Yeah.
That makes the difference at that stage.
What is this last one? I can't even see that. Oh, documentaries and music videos. So right now, we're mainly narrative. You know, we'll take... animated projects, things like that.
We haven't had one yet.
But we'll take those submissions.
Yeah.
But music videos, we haven't carved that out yet. If you have a short film, narrative short film that includes a lot of music video-esque type of, you know, scenes, or it's a musical itself, yeah, we're into taking a look at it. But straight up music videos, I mean, you can apply, but you probably won't get it. I'll just tell you that. Documentary, because we have a system of how we're accepting applications, we have readers that will go through it. It's a little bit more standardized. Once we introduce documentary, we will have to kind of regroup and reconsider how documentarians apply, because it's a whole different process. Mm-hmm. It's a whole different pitch with documentary. So I hope that we get to that in the future, but right now it's just narrative filmmaking. What are we looking for? I just kind of went over some of this, but yeah. I mean, we're just looking for interesting storytelling, interesting filmmaking, and not to say that music videos and documentaries aren't that, of course. But yeah, we're just looking for something that grabs us. The writing has to be solid. If you're an experimental filmmaker and you don't really write traditional scripts, you can still submit, but you have to paint a very clear picture of what your intentions are. Of course, if you have limited avenues to finding financing or gear, we love to, you know, hear those stories where
that's
this film
who we're
wouldn't
trying
have happened
to find, yeah.
without us. That's awesome. You know, that,
yeah, and every single grantee has said that.
Of course, we went over the age, mm-hmm. 35 or younger. This is a new addition, which is we are having a cutoff for filmmakers that have had two projects in more than two of the major industry film festivals. That would be, you know, Cannes or Sundance or Berlin, just to kind of level the playing field a little bit. So if you have been in those festivals, that's okay, but we're putting a cutoff.
Yeah, once you've had two different projects in two major festivals, you've kind of graduated from our category of emerging.
Yeah,
and we're happy.
Although
but
I know you still need help getting your
yeah,
films financed.
Yeah, it's
you know,
still hard, but
we're in the same
but,
boat. But
yeah,
we're
getting the ones right before that moment. We're trying to get the other guys that want to go to those festivals.
Yeah, and we're hoping that yeah. the other ones that have been are the ones that come on as mentors and as readers
yes.
and come into the foundation in a different way, not as opposed to a grantee. Let's see. Oh, and the other thing is that it has to be feasible. It has to actually be a project that can be made. If you submit something that seems so outlandish,
mm-hmm.
you know, if it seems like it's outlandish but intriguing enough for us to
but doable.
Yeah, but if we inquire about it and it still seems doable, for example, Nick Dixon's film called Mine, he uses a lot of visual effects and things like that because his day job is being a visual effects supervisor, so he kind of had access to all of that, which was great. But the bottom line is his story was still what got him the grant. The fact that he could,
yeah.
you know, CG some other elements in,
right.
awesome. But
yeah, if you're trying to make like Jurassic World as a short, and you need to explode a bunch of things and have like mechanical dinosaurs in addition to a bunch of CGI,
then your writing had better be good enough for us.
It better be great. But then even at the level where we get to it and it's really great writing,
we might have to pass.
Yeah, we might have to say, can this filmmaker pull this off in these 8 months? And are they going to be able to do it with our little $5,000?
But with
maybe
that said,
not.
You can also use our money as just
a
part of your budget.
Yeah.
So if you have a
right,
access
that might
to other funding, and really you're just looking
yeah.
for that last $5,000.
Yeah. So then we
awesome.
Come to you and we're like, this project sounds nuts.
But
you know,
cool.
we want to ask you a little more about it, and then they're like, well, we've already filmed the explosion. We've already got the guy that wears the dinosaur
line.
Suit. Yeah, yeah, like, we're just looking for this last little bit. Then that opens
then,
it up.
Then
but
it opens up.
Feasibility is a big one. And in that process, you know, we might look at past work from the filmmaker to see what
yes.
they've done. It's not like a totally blind assessment.
Let's see.
So oh. if you get the grant, this is what we require of you.
So we have an annual it's kind of like our annual film festival. It's a showcase where we screen all of our grantees' films, and it's awesome and fun, and we fly our grantees in.
As well as the jurors.
House them, and yeah, last year we flew in 2 jurors. I think it'll change on availability every year, but so, you know, we'll get to the why it's so awesome, but as well as screening at the showcase, you also are kind of committing to being a mentor for the next year's filmmakers and just kind of sharing your experience and any advice that you have or things that you may have learned along the
Or resources, which was great, which happened between Ben Keegan, our first grantee, and then the other four. Now they're like, hey, well, you know, checking in with Ben, and he's like, well, that you could use this or that in New York or this or that.
And he's good at talking up his experience because I think he really fell in love with Utah.
Yeah.
Which is great.
Yeah, he came back. That was great. Our first grantee came back for our second showcase.
Just to be there.
Which I feel like attests to what a good experience it is.
And then you have to have regular check-ins with your mentor and the foundation contacts. A lot of it is with me calling up and seeing, oh, how's the edit coming, or do you need anything from me? And then, of course, you must have your film. The main thing you really have to do is have the film done by the showcase. Otherwise, you're in trouble, and we're in trouble. So this next one is coming up in April 2017. We're actually shifting it out of winter and into the spring, which is a good thing for you guys in Miami who don't like snow. We've touched on some of this, but what our foundation provides: mentorship, friendship, parentheses, hugs, lots of hugs, lots of support, peers and network. You know, if you are confused about, you know, things, anything with that distribution or sound design or anything, we make ourselves available to help you out and talk you through things. We connect you with our partner organizations, Film Exchange and Avrick Art House, as well as provide festival assistance. You know, this year is their first year we're getting, or we have a administrative assistant on our staff, so she will be contacting festivals to try to get waiver fees and things like that. So
yeah, we really want our films, you know, the films that we help to produce. Yeah, we screen them, but we don't want it to end there. We want to make sure that we're setting up the filmmakers to do something with the shorts that they've made. So stuff like festival waivers is important. We had 2 that went to South by this year, which were currently. We're thrilled. So that's exactly the kind of thing that we want to facilitate, is getting the films made, building relationships, and then building a future for the films and a future for the filmmakers. That's definitely a big part of our goal.
And then we talked about this already, but we really try to take care of you and give you show you a good time and host you when you're in Salt Lake City for your big screening. It's not your premiere, because we don't like to call them premieres, because we want our grantees to actually go on to festivals and have their premiere. So
it's a private event.
It's a private event that is so much fun. This is a still of Ted Schaefer's short film, which was shot in New York. Our other board member, Dustin DeFay, who's a New York filmmaker, really helped him and mentored him and helped him find his casting. You may recognize that kid from, I believe, in Unicorns, indie film. So our website. Our website is a great resource, and especially the frequently asked questions page, because we get a lot of questions and we try to update. It's getting quite long. We need to rein it in, but we try to answer our questions and post them on the site. So read that, look it over, and you know, if you still have questions, please reach out to us, because we're pretty fast at responding, and you know, we want to make the process as smooth as possible. I should also say, when you do go on without a box to submit, in previous years we had kind of a more lengthy application process. This year it's you just create an account, upload your script, and submit to our foundation. So it's extremely fast and easy. We took out all of the other stuff. Because we're really basing this on your writing. And once you get, you know, past the, if your project is picked to become a finalist, someone will reach out to you and get after you for, you know, other examples of work and things like that. But at the submission process, we just want it to be easy. So all you have to do is upload your script, which is great.
16-page limit. Did we say that?
Yes, 16-page
limit.
But you know, we've applied for grants ourselves, and we know it's such a hair pulling, stressful.
Process. The longer the process, the worse you feel.
And so we just want to remove that. And
yeah.
You know,
we'll get to know you later. Just give us your darn script.
Your background is less important to us because we don't care if you go to film school. We don't care if you have a master's degree in film. We don't care if you've made a bunch of other short films before or this is your first. We really are looking for good material, and you know, we're not an organization that's just trying to find, you know, encourage our friends to apply. It's really, we want to just have a very broad and open submission process that is easy and accessible. So, yeah, check it out. It's very straightforward. This is kind of the end of our presentation.
This
so
goes to black.
Follow us on social media. We update that kind of stuff pretty often with deadlines, as well as other, you know, useful
like what our grantees are doing,
yeah,
too.
Cool things and useful information. You know, any articles we come across, you know, we'll share them with you there. We're on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And it's just a good idea to follow us so you don't end up missing your deadline, because nothing's worse than going on and logging on and thinking, oh, I still have a week, and no, it was a week
nothing's
ago.
Nothing's worse than what wasn't.
Yep. So yeah, that is it. We can open it for questions if anyone has any questions. Back there, yeah.
Do you guys accept episodic stuff, like if it's like something for a short series?
That is a great question. The question was if we accept episodic stuff. Really, if you have an idea for this short film to become part of an episode, that's great, but really, it still has to fall within our category. So it still has to be 16 pages or less. Whether you are going to expand on that and create more episodes after that, that is totally up to you. But it should still be a well-rounded short film in itself. You know, if you look at, like, Curb Your Enthusiasm, that's a great example of, like, an episodic program that has a very rounded structure where it has a conclusion. Not that all short films have to have a conclusion by any means. But, you know, it is, each episode is a little film within itself. You really feel that way. So this same thing. We're not opposed to episodic stuff. It's just that that won't be our focus. That won't be the reason why we choose your project.
Right. Yeah, because we want our audience that comes to the showcase to see a short film without having to understand this outer structure. So, for example, Lauren Wolkstein's film was part of a series that, and it's the larger grouping of films that went to South by, actually. And it was, what is the name of it?
Bemis to the Lineage.
No, the name of the...
Conscious Unconscious?
Conscious Unconscious. So,
no, excuse me, Collective Unconscious.
Collective Unconscious. So it was a group of filmmakers that were assembled by a guy.
Yes, Dan Schoenbrunn.
And it was a group of where they made other people's dreams into short films. So that was an example of something that was part of a series, but that stood alone very well. So her
film... So it's
now
going to South By as a feature instead of a short film. It's being lumped into one larger project, but it still stands alone as a short film.
Right, and she just submitted it not as a part of that, just as its own thing. Mm-hmm. So there's ways that it works and makes sense.
Any yes?
Have you seen any deadlines?
Oh, okay, so we'll go back. The question is what were the deadlines? And March 22nd is the regular deadline, so that's coming up pretty soon. And then the late deadline is April 12th.
And then we make announcements on June what?
June 30th.
June 30th.
Is when you'll hear from us.
Yes. And then your film has to be done by the showcase in April of 2017. So you'll have, what is that, 9 months?
Mm-hmm.
You can make a baby and a film. Just kidding. That sounds like a nightmare to do both at the same time.
Yeah.
So, if I were to write a script for a short, let's say I don't know any crew members where I live, do you guys help with that at all? Or help find people, crew members?
Yeah, we can. I mean, that can potentially be limiting or awesome. You know, it depends on what city you're coming from.
Right.
For example, Ted, who is our grantee, lives in the same city as Dustin, who's another board member and filmmaker. So that really worked out. If you live in small town Virginia, right now, in our network, I don't know if I can point you to anyone.
Yeah, we'll do whatever.
But we'll do our best.
Yeah.
We'll put our...
In the peer-to-peer sense. It's not something that the foundation currently has the actual infrastructure to do, but anything that we can, you know, peer-to-peer, we're definitely happy to share. And Averick for, like, the local grant, and let's just pretend that our national grant wanted to come shoot in Utah.
Sure.
Then at that point, our partners would, Averick Art House would say, hey, we know these day players, or we know, these crew members that you might be able to get in touch with. And so that's like, that extends our ability to...
But either way, I think we'll assist
share
you.
Resources.
You know, if you have no idea where to start, A, I really hope that's not the case, but B...
Yeah, that gets into the feasibility territory.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
We can kind of dip into our network. Everyone knows someone. Friends of friends. That's how films get made, you know.
Absolutely.
So if you're making a film in Texas, awesome. Florida, awesome.
Yeah,
New York, great.
The
Northwest, great.
The Film Exchange is another really great resource.
In Texas.
Victoria, Texas, small town. They've run a fantastic short film festival up there.
No, it's a
or
great
it's a bit run. It's everything.
It's everything.
Shut up. Anthony Padonia, who heads that up, or actually he just passed it on to Elizabeth Spear, but he started it. He's a great connector. He's got lots of people all over that region. So that's another entity that is an extension sort of ourselves by way of collaboration that is a good...
Yeah, and he just loves filmmakers.
And that's our gear partner.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and he loves filmmakers. He loves connecting people. He's a good festival. He goes to every damn festival ever.
That's great.
So.
Is that it? I think we're probably at about time right now.
Students can apply. That's a question that...
Yeah,
Nobody asked, but I'm answering.
And this is also U.S. residents or people living in the U.S. and studying, going to school here, apply. We don't take international applications right now because we don't really have the infrastructure to ship a camera overseas or do anything like that. So
it gets a little out of,
yeah, so
it's
right
not
now,
feasible
it's just,
for us right now. It's not that we don't want to do it, but right now, we're still growing.
Still growing. Is that it? I think we can wrap it up then. Thanks for coming, everyone. This was awesome, especially you. we will post this up online, and hopefully it will be a helpful guide for people looking to apply. So, thanks, guys.